Hey guys, welcome to Being Engineers. I'm Shovik, and in this video I'll be making a digital clock using Arduino. Already 2 months back I've already made a binary clock using Arduino using the chaliplexing concept, and this was the product at the end of that video. But after posting that video I just realized that binary clock is not for everyone, because not everyone can read binary clock at a glance obviously, but everyone can read about digital clock. So I'll be making digital clock, and this is the final product of today's video. Already I have made this before starting this video, so I'll be giving out this to any of my subscriber for the 5k subs, and just as a return. So if you want any of those, then just comment down anything in my video, in this video obviously, any hi, hello, whatever you will do. Also you have to subscribe to my channel, because that is quite obvious. And talking about this PCB, is that this PCB I got from JLC PCB. They are also the sponsor for this video, so big thumbs up to JLC PCB for sponsoring for this video. They really make good quality PCBs with very cost effective way and quick build time. And I got 10 of these PCB just for $2, so each PCB costed for 20 cents, and with the all other components it costed total around $3 to make the whole thing here. And to know more about the website and the ordering process, stay tuned with me, because I'll be telling you at the later of the part of the video. That's it here. So without further ado, let's start the video from here. We'll start by drawing the schematic for the project. There will be basic 4 blocks in the circuit. First, there will be a power supply module to provide the required 5 volt to the board. Second is the RTC module with the DS1307 IC and its peripherals. Third will be the microcontroller itself, that is the ATmega 328P in this case, and the last is the 4x7 segment LED display. So keeping these things in mind, we can now draw the schematic. Generally I use EasyEDA to draw all kind of electronic circuit diagram, and this time will be no exception. Also I opened up EasyEDA and I gathered all the required components from the library and wired them with the proper connection by the wire tool that was given in the portal. Also, you can see the PCB layout and the parts itself in the component website, that is the lcsc.com. You can take a look at the component before using it in your project. Also, you can see the price. Also, you can check if there is any alternative that is cheaper than that. So this is the final circuit that I came up with. You can see here is the main power supply that I was talking earlier with the 7805 voltage regulator. This is the IC DS1307, that is the RTC. Here you can see the 28-pin ATmega 328P microcontroller with the passive components that is need to run. Actually, this whole system will be a DIY Arduino on board. But for more information on this, how to make a DIY Arduino, you can check my previous video. You can find the link in the I button there. Then this whole section is the LED segment display that is give us the visual indication of the time, and it requires some transistor to drive it. So these are those. Once you are done with this, it's time to generate the BOM and make a final list of the required components. This BOM is also given in the description box below, so if you want you can take a glance at it. Also you can see the component list on the screen now. Choke down if you want, if you feel it necessary, otherwise you can let it go. Now gather all these components, we are proceeding further. Now you can see I simulated the whole circuit in Proteus also. And there the clock is working in simulation as it was intended to do in real. So I'm confident that the circuit that I made is correct here. Now save the circuit diagram and convert the schematic to PCB. This is the best part of EasyEDA. Designing a PCB is so easy and slow fluent in this portal that people with no major experience in PCB designing can get the job done. Till the time you don't need any super complex PCBs with thousands of components on it, or in fully industrial grade design, you don't need to use those fancy EDA softwares like Eagle or other high-end professional designing softwares. Those are already great, but for our use, EasyEDA will be sufficient. But when designing a PCB, you have to be cautious all the time, because a small mistake here can ruin your whole PCB package. Use DRC to confirm the PCB has no error. Don't use 90 degree parts to connect two pads. Also use copper area as ground. It will save some time for the routing, and it is always recommended because it dissipates the heat over the area. You can also put your own logo, your own text on the top or bottom layer of the PCB, as you can see I've done that in this PCB.
But the main thing is that there is a tool named 3D model, and you must use it, I say, because I find it very useful. What happens if you have done some error in layer management in your text or whatever, you can see the thing visually on the 3D model, then you can correct it. So use that, and finally check your PCB before generating the Gerber file. Once you generate the Gerber file, you can order those boards via JLCPCB directly from there. It will take you to jlcpcb.com. There you have to upload the Gerber files. Change any settings if you want, but for the most of the cases, the standard given options are fine to go. Then save the order to cart and pay to place the order. You can see the total price of $2 that I was talking about earlier. The ridiculously low price and quick build time of only 24 hours is not something you're gonna get elsewhere. So that's why I use JLCPCB all the time. Also, the shipping is super quick. You know, you can get the PCBs delivered to your door in maybe 4 to 5 days, I guess, because I live in India and I generally get those PCBs via DHL in 5 days. Oh, by the way, you can always check the shipping status and the production status right from your account page. Just as a side note, if you are not familiar with these terms that I'm showing you on the screen right now, you should find this video helpful, that is there on the website homepage. I'll also give the link in the description box, take a look. Once the PCBs have arrived, open it and inspect the quality. This is how I received the package from DHL, and this is the PCB that I have ordered. At first glance, it looks pretty promising, isn't it? The silk screen, solder mask, tunneling, everything looks flawless. If you're happy with the quality, then let's start with the soldering process now. It took me around an hour to solder all the components in place. I don't have a soldering station of those kind of thing, so I did it with a $5 soldering iron, and for me it wasn't causing any problem. That's it, and this is the final product. One thing you might find odd in this PCB that all the components are on the top layer of the PCB except some resistors and a 3-volt battery. I did it intentionally to reduce the size of the board. That's completely your choice. It doesn't matter at all. As long as the connections are proper, everything will work as it was intended to do. Another thing is that you may find odd that there are two LEDs on board. One is for power indication, obviously we all know, but the second is for what? Actually, this is a 3mm LED that I connected with the analog pin 0 or the A0 pin of the microcontroller. I can use it with a blink program to check the onboard DIY Arduino is working or not. This is how I like it to be. I always put it on the PCB. You can remove the LED from your schematic if you want. It doesn't matter that way. When everything is completed, insert the DS1307 IC in the socket and then place a CR2032 3-volt cell at the back. Now you need to fit the correct time and date on the RTC chip. To do that, make the following connections. SCL of Arduino Uno to the pin 28 of the IC socket in the PCB. SD of Arduino Uno to pin 27 of the socket, and then common the ground with both the boards. Now power up the PCB with a power adapter. Any 9 to 12 volt DC adapter will work because the 7005 will be converting that to 5 volt anyway. So this way the DS1307 IC is powered now. Now what you have to do, you have to connect the Arduino to the computer and open Arduino IDE and open this sketch. You can find the link of this sketch in the description box of the video. You can download that and use that. Here you have to do that, you have to update the time and date in the code. Maybe with respect to your system date and time, you can change that, and you have to upload it to the Arduino. What the Arduino will do that, it will send the data by the I2C protocol to the RTC module, and the RTC module will be storing the time and date on its memory. Now from this point, the 3-volt cell that I attached previously on the back will come into play. What it will do, that it will power up the DS1307 from now on, even if the main power is off. That's why the clock will be running continuously, just like you can find a 3-volt cell there in the motherboard of your computer which powers the RTC to keep the correct time in it. So when the time is set, remove all the connections between the Arduino and the PCB. Now we have to upload the main code to the Arduino. So upload this code to the Arduino. The code is also given in the description box. Download it and use it. The code now has stored into the Atmel 1820 PIC. So now what we will be doing, we will be removing the IC from the Arduino and we'll be placing the IC on the PCB socket, that is a 28-pin IC socket. After inserting the IC on the socket, power up the board, and if you have done everything correctly till now, then the light segment should light up with numbers and will give you the current time in 24 hours format. Yeah, obviously you can change it to 12 hours format with some modification in the code. Also, you'll be finding a small dot blinking every 1 second in the middle that will denote the clock is running. If you find the LEDs are too dim or too bright for your view, then you can adjust the value of the variable D in the code. So that's it, you have successfully made this project. Now you have a digital clock to place on your desk. Yeah, I know this type of clock is not something out of the box idea. These are very common and readily available in market in a cheap price. But able to make it from scratch can give you a good level of satisfaction, I guess. At least it works for me that way. I don't know what for yours, but I hope you like this project. And if you have liked this project, then please let us know by liking this video or at least put a comment with your inputs in the comment box of this video. Do subscribe to our channel. Keep motivating us to produce more and more videos for you. Also, don't forget about the giveaway that I said earlier. I'll be giving away this clock to someone of you. So you have to just comment this video and you have to subscribe to our channel to participate in this. I'll be giving out the result in next video. Till then, goodbye and take care.